no picture taking. But it doesn't say anything about no video taking, so.
Good morning, Cebu City. It was beautiful before the day, but right now it's a little bit cloudy. There are some clouds coming up. As long as it's not raining, I'm okay. Okay, today I'm going to do some little exploring here around the city. So let's go. Tourist mode activated.
Starting with the most classical tourist spots here in the Cebu City, the Magellan Cross. Look at this.
Okay, this point, the Magellan Cross, represents two things. First of all, the very beginning of the colonization of the Philippines, but also representing the very beginning of Christianity here in the country, which is huge nowadays. So you may like it or you may not like it. This is still one of the biggest events marking the history of the Philippines. I don't know if it's the actual cross that they brought here or the cross representing Magellan bringing it here.
It might even be the original cross. Signage there, it says this cross of Trindalo wood encases the original cross planted by Ferdinand Magellan on this very site. Inside that cross, there's the very original cross brought by Magellan. Okay, we can see it here. You see Magellan coming with the boat, with his fellows, preaching and bringing the Christianity to the locals exactly 500 years ago. 1521. Okay, let's keep exploring now.
Hi.
Hi. And now let's take a look at the Basilica Minore del Santo Niño de Cebu.
Appalachian sunrise meets my skin. Even with my eyes still closed, I can feel it coming. Golden, golden, I'll follow only golden, 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 golden things. Mountain laurel high fives for miles in spring. Rainbow trout and a hummingbird.
Today is, what's today? Today is Wednesday. Not only Sunday people go to church here, any day of the week. As you can see here, there are so many people around. They bring their candles. They do their prayers. Okay, let's now continue with the tour, because I'm now here, the Basilica del Santo Niño. This is actually the very first church here in the Philippines. So let's take a look inside. I mean, there is no mass going on at the moment, no ceremony at all whatsoever. But there are still people here coming and show their devotion to the Santo Niño. People are queuing up just to go there and bring a little greetings. Oh, that flower just fell. Anyway, the Santo Niño is actually a statue of the baby Jesus Christ. Also another gift from the Spanish colonization. Anyway, let's try to go there and take a look at it. So in the middle, we also have this beautiful patio here. No picture take, but it doesn't say anything about no video taking, so. Okay, I have to say, it was kinda a moving experience. I can see people like on their knees, a lot of people crying, or you can see it in their eyes, super emotional. You can really see how much it means to them and how much devoted they are to the Santo Niño and to the Christianity. So yeah, a must visit. Check it out, the Basilica del Santo Niño.